Hey everybody, and welcome back to another very special episode of 13-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 13 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. So why is this episode so special? Well, after 4 years of creating tutorials for you guys, I have finally broken 10,000 subscribers. Now, I get in the world of YouTube, 10,000 subs isn't super impressive, but I'm extremely grateful for the collective of designers who, over the years, have continued to watch, share, like, and subscribe to my channel. So thank you very much. I am very, very grateful. Moving forward, let's make this channel explode so that way I can continue making these tutorials for all you guys. Okay, in today's episode, I'm going to create a very cool neon sign, completely within After Effects, no third-party plugins. But as is usual with my tutorials, you'll be learning a lot more along the way. This neon sign is created 100% within After Effects using no third-party plugins. Just a bit of text, a shape layer, a few layer styles, and some fancy precomping. You can grab free backgrounds at freecreatives.com. Just head to the URL on screen and either take a look through their backgrounds or search for something like brick wall or concrete. These textures are 100% free and can add a lot to your designs. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's go ahead and set up our project here. I've created a composition, and as you can see, it's 1920 by 1080, 29.97 frames, and we're going to make this about 6 seconds long. I'm going to bring in this concrete wall, so we're going to drop that in here. Hit S to bring up our scale and just kind of size this down. Make that 3D. Let's go to Layer, New, Camera, and let's just go ahead and create a camera. You can use the default camera and Layer, New, Null Object. We're going to make that 3D, and let's parent our camera to the null object and rename this null camera control. I'm gonna go ahead and highlight both of these layers and give them a single color so that way we can differentiate them. And while we're doing that, let's make our layer for our background, set it to none. Okay, so now let's create a new adjustment layer, and I'm gonna call this color control. Go to effect, expression controls, color control. If you hit return, you can rename this. We'll name this text color, and then duplicate that and name the second one box color. Okay, and I'm going to make my text color like a light blue. And I'm going to make my box color orange. Control T to bring up our text tool. And I'm just going to type Jeff Knight. And for now, I'm going to go ahead and hide this concrete background. And let's just make this larger. If you right click, go to Transform, Center Anchor Point and Layer Content. Go to our Line panel, and then we'll just center that right up. I only want to use a stroke for this. I don't want to use a fill. So let's go to our character panel. See how our stroke is not engaged, but our fill is. Well, let's click on the fill setting and mark that out, and then our stroke will come up. So you just click on that, make that white. And I want to set this to 10 pixels. Kind of spread this out a little bit. Okay, and now let's precompose our text layer. So let's go to layer, precompose, and we'll call this text. And we'll go inside of our text layer here. And now let's right click, we're gonna create shapes from our text layer. So with our shape layer highlighted, let's go up to our search bar here and just type in line cap. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab all of these line caps. I'm on a PC, so I'm holding down control as I click all of these. So make sure you highlight all of the line caps. And we're gonna change those from butt cap to round cap. And then we're gonna type line join and do the same thing with that. With any layer highlighted, you can type in any attribute that you want to isolate, and then it will come up whenever you type it up in this search bar here. Control A to grab all of those and collapse them down. And then I'm gonna add a trim paths. And then let's set our end percentage to 95. And so see, that will kind of give us these little gaps in here. Now, if you rotate this offset, it'll kind of put these in random places. And actually, I'm going to make my stroke maybe a little bit thinner. See, right now it's set to 10 pixels. Let's make that more like 7. Now let's choose layer, new shape layer. And we're just going to make a simple rectangle. So let's add a rectangle and give that rectangle a stroke. Leave that rectangle color white. And let's make the stroke 10 pixels wide. And then just stretch this out so it encircles our text. Now let's increase our roundness here for our rectangle to 20 pixels. As we did with our text, we're going to add in a trim paths, and let's change this end percentage 97. And see, it's here in the top right corner. I'm just going to move that around to somewhere like about right there. And you can put these little gaps anywhere you want. The main purpose for doing this is to make it look like a neon sign. Okay, so now if we go back out to our main comp here, we have our color control. So if you click on this padlock here, that will lock our effects panel. So now I can click away, but this effects panel will stay up there. So see, if I go back to my text layer now, go into my box here, open up my stroke, and we're going to parent the stroke color to the box color and see it'll turn orange immediately. And then for our text layer, let's go to effect, generate, fill, and hit E to bring up your effects. And let's just parent our fill color to the text color. So now it's blue. Before I unlock this, I just want to give you an idea of how easy it is to change these colors. So see, whatever I change these colors to, it will automatically update. So I'm gonna go back to the original colors I had, this blue and orange. And then let's unlock this effect control panel so that way we're not always stuck in that panel there. Okay, so now let's duplicate this text layer. And then we want to precompose this second text layer, the one that's on top. Layer, precompose, and we're going to call this glow and click OK. So now if we go into our glow layer here, let's make two copies of these so that way we'll have a total of three copies. On this bottom layer, we're going to add in fast box blur, set that to 10. And let's just rename this blur. Let's go into this second layer here. And we want to go to layer, layer styles, and we're going to add in an inner glow and open up our inner glow. And we want to make sure we have this source defaults to edge. So set that to center and let's leave our size at 5. And let's go up to effect, stylize, and let's add in a glow. And then for our top layer, so the layer, layer styles, bevel emboss, and just open up the bevel emboss and let's reduce our shadow opacity down to about 50 and our highlight opacity down to 0. And then we also need to add in our inner glow and open that up. And again, we want to change our source from edge to center. See, this is really kind of starting to come together. You're kind of getting an idea of how this is going to look whenever it's finished. Let's go back out to our main comp here. And then for our text layer, let's just solo that. We're going to add in a fill effect, generate fill. And we want this color to be like a dark, dark gray. Okay, and then we need to add in some layer styles. So we're going to add in first a bevel and emboss. And see, this is kind of getting that wire kind of look to it. And then let's go to layer, layer styles, and let's add in a drop shadow. And adjust some of these settings, open up our drop shadow. We want our distance to be 40 and our size to be 20. And you can really see how that's going to look by enabling this opacity. So see, this is going to be our shadow here. And then let's move our angle around to 55, so it kind of falls off to the lower left side. Let's turn back on our concrete background layer, and then we want to add in layer new light, add in a spotlight, and make the intensity 150, cone angle 50, and cone feather 100%, and just click OK. If you hit P on your spotlight, let's just center up our spotlight here with our comp. So let's make this 960 by 540, and we want to pull it back negative 1500 pixels. I need to really darken this background. So let's go to effect, color correction, curves, and I'm going to just really darken this background. And let's go to effect, color correction, tint. And then I'm going to leave this at about 50%. I don't want it to be 100% black and white, but I also don't want it to be completely saturated. So we're going to leave that at 50% there. And now see, if we turn off this top glow here, you can see that this is what our wire looks like by itself, which is kind of cool. It definitely works. Let's go back into our text layer here, into our layer styles, and let's just make the opacity for this drop shadow. I'm going to put it up to 100%, so it's a little bit darker, and maybe even move it down another few pixels. This is just some tweaks you can do to it just to kind of get the right look that you're going for. My final settings here are going to be, my angle is going to be 50, my distance is 50, and my size is 20. Okay, so now let's duplicate this glow layer and then move it underneath our text layer. So let's go to effect, blur and sharpen, add a Gaussian blur, and let's make that blur 150 pixels. And then we want to set our track mode to add. Okay, and now I want my glow to kind of spark onto life. So hit T on both of our glow layers. Let's grab our opacity from this lower glow layer and just parent that to the opacity on our top glow layer. So see, whatever we change the top to, the bottom will also change. Let's put a keyframe at the very beginning of this layer for 0%, and you want to right click and toggle hold keyframe because we want this to kind of spark on and we don't want it to fade in. Go maybe about 10 frames and make that 100%. And now just kind of randomly add in 0% to 100% at least two frames apart, but no more than five. So I'm gonna go page down 1, 2, make that 0, go down one, another 1, 2, 3, 4, make that 100, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 100, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe make that 0, then 1, 2, 3, make that 100. Just so that way it's a little bit random. If we kind of watch that back, we can see how this is gonna look like it's kind of sparking to life. So see, that looks right. Now let's go up to our camera control and hit P and R to bring up our position and rotation. We're gonna put a keyframe for our position, another keyframe for our Y rotation only, and put those keyframes at the beginning of our layer here. And now let's just make our Y rotation 10. Oh, and don't forget, we need to make our glow and text layers. Those need to all be 3D as well. So make sure those are enabled 3D, so that way our camera will affect it. So see, let's just kind of move around here and see what we got. On our X rotation, let's move that back 10 degrees so it's kind of sitting back. And also, I want our background to feel like it's behind our sign. Hit P to bring up position. Let's just push this back on the Z axis, let's say about 50 pixels. So as it's moving around, we have more of a sense of depth here. Go to about 5 seconds. And let's put a keyframe for our Y rotation just in the opposite direction. So negative 10. Now I like to bring up my guides and then I like to kind of push in a little bit here at the end. So see, we want this to end in a centered position. I may make this Y rotation a little bit more extreme. And now let's just increase our background. As you can see right here, we can start to see the transparency behind it. So just hit S to bring up our scale and we'll just increase that. So that way that fits better within our comp and you can kind of adjust where this is positioned. Let's go to our spotlight and hit T to bring up our intensity. And we're just going to put a wiggle expression on the intensity. So alt click on to intensity. You just type in wiggle 1, 15. And then let's also open up our cone angle. Alt click on that and type wiggle 1, 7. So this is going to fluctuate our angle as scrub through. You can kind of see how it's kind of coming in and out like that. And we may want to make this angle a little bit bigger. So that way our sign isn't obscured. Okay, and then let's hit P on our camera control and alt click on our position. And let's just add a wiggle for that. It'll go 1, 5. And this just kind of gives a little bit more randomness and life to our design here. So I'm just going to kind of tweak with this background color a little bit more. So this is basically what we're going for. And now see, if we go back to our color control, I'm just going to bring this to the very top. Again, you can instantly change these colors to anything you want. So it really does help at the very beginning to set that up and to make a color control layer. And that's how you make a very quick neon sign.
I hope that helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. Click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. And don't forget to sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive, easy to follow course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers. Learn how to create, use, and incorporate shape layers into all of your After Effects projects. The link for that course, as well as the project files for this episode and the settings I used to create the neon sign, are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching my channel and helping it grow over the years. I'll see you next time with another very cool tutorial.